Custom Gang. We back with another video, man. Guess what? Yeah, we back on it. Back on the hood, man. We're gonna try to get this thing knocked out today. So all I gotta do now is really just sand down the front and sand the rest of it. So let's get started. Sanding it 320. I got a bridge back, right? Like a soft pad. Like a soft block pad. Get it sanded, man. Alright, Custom Gang, for the mix up our cell. We got our MP127. Mix is 4-1. It's a matrix soak. This is the activator that goes in it. MA122. Slow. I wish I had a fast one, but this is all I got right now. So I gotta use what I got. Should have used my shaker for this, but I did. So I'm doing it over, hold it. Paint pack, stir it up. Okay, take that off. I ain't gonna put two big coats on that hood, man. I see they got a lot of damage on it. Got a lot of scratches in it, too. Put the little trick on the boots with the hand grips, none of that. Thank you.
All right, we don't lay down too close to ceiling. As you can see, remember what I said, that this hood is really wavy, man. It's real wavy. I don't know if y'all can see it in here, but yeah. You can see like right out there. It's real wavy. But like I said, man, I got a trick for it. So, let's quit talking. Get this bass on there. Got that black base laid down. Gotta let this tack off. And we're gonna be getting to the surprise, man. Let's hold your horses. Yes, sir. We're gonna make old Lump Lump look like something. Got two tricks that I could do. But, I'm gonna go with the one that I first thought of, cause I think it'll turn out pretty good with that. So that's on the road with it. Or should I say, several tricks that I can do to make this hood look better than what it is, than what it was, should I say? Alright, as y'all can see, I got something stretched over this thing. I'm gonna show y'all what I'm gonna do with it. If you know what it is, you know what I'm finna do? Smash that like button and comment down below. I had to stop right there to show y'all the process. Basically what I'm doing, as you can see, making the hood look carbon fiber. Have the carbon fiber print, should I say. And all you have to do is lay down this mat. You can get this at like Lowe's, Home Depot, Walmart. You know, just a little stuff to go in your kitchen drawer. The little non-skid thing. But anyway, all you got to do, spread a section, move it over. And when you move it over, try to line it up. If we can focus, try to line it up right on your little dots. If you can line it up on your dots, you're good to go for the next row. Let me show you. Basically, just like that. That's pretty much lined up on my dots. So I'm ready to shoot my next row. Just gotta check everywhere else. There we go, get that centered up. And I'm ready to shoot my next one. Simple as that. So let's get her done. All right, what y'all think? Yeah. That carbon fiber look on it, man. Looks pretty good, don't it? There's one more step that I gotta do to this. I'm gonna show y'all in a second. But, you know, only thing you gotta worry about is like stuff like this. As you can see, that slip rug, mat that I was using, it had little ripples in it. Now, if you used to lay it out in the sun and get all the ripples out of it, you won't have no spots that show up like this. See right there? Right there. Right there, right there, right there, right there, right there. But anyway, y'all get the idea of how to do it. Real simple, man. Real simple. And it was another idea that I was gonna do. I was gonna actually do bowling ball. I end up doing that in another video, showing y'all on some other project down the road. But yeah, turned out pretty good, man. I mean, it ain't perfect, but I got it. So what y'all think, man? Let me know in the comments below. All right, what I'm gonna do now is ghost it in. I got me some reduced black. I almost made it like a candy where the black is transparent. Show you what I'm gonna do. All right, custom gang, I put my tint on there. As you can see, it darkened it up a little bit. Exactly what I wanted. It gives it that real carbon fiber look. Cause you know, carbon fiber, you can't see the colors are there on the carbon fiber, but it has like that little tint over it. If you ever look at carbon fiber really good, pretty sure most of y'all have. But yeah, this is the trick that I was talking about. Even though I'm gonna be clearing it, when I clear it, you're still gonna see a lot of that stuff, a lot of those waves up in there. But that carbon fiber is gonna kind of throw you off when you look at it. So we'll see. We will see. But yeah, man, the carbon fiber turned out pretty good. Just a little cheap and expensive way for you to get the carbon fiber to look without paying the carbon fiber price. So let's mix up and clear and get this thing cleared. Here come the smoky part. We'll be right back.
All right, y'all, this is my third coat.
All right, custom gang, y'all see it. It got some trash in it, but it's nothing that handy dandy 3000 super duper rotisserie buffer can't get out, baby. It ain't gonna take out them lumps, but it's gonna take out them chunks. So hey, that's what I'm gonna do. Really, I ain't worried about none of that, man, because, like I said, I'm going to be replacing the hood, so I ain't going to go too far with it. I might nib it a little bit, then polish it, but other than that, man, I think it looked pretty good, though. What y'all think? Let me know. Let me know. I can't say that thing is wet. Yes, sir. Ooh-wee. Look at that trash. It's alright. We ain't gonna worry about that. We can make that disappear. Yeah. This hood has came a long ways, man. A long ways. A very long way. But it looks okay. Turned out a little better than what I expected. What y'all think? Yeah. Gang, and just like that. Y'all see it in the background, man. We got this hood laid out, baby. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and don't forget to holler at your boy. Sweet guy.